चैनल के अंदर हम लोगों ने चैप्टर नंबर 5 के थ्योरी पार्ट को खत्म कर लिया है. नाउ वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन द एक्सरसाइज सॉल्यूशन पार्ट. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट विल बी द मिनिमम प्रेशर रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्रेस 500 डेसीमीटर क्यूब्स ऑफ एयर एट 1 बार टू 200 डेसीमीटर क्यूब्स ऑफ एयर एट 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस. तो देखिए यहां पर आपका टेम्परेचर जो है वो कॉन्स्टेंट है. टेम्परेचर कॉन्स्टेंट है तो व्हाट वी कैन राइट अकॉर्डिंग टू बॉयल्स लॉ एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर अकॉर्डिंग टू बॉयल्स लॉ एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर व्हाट वी कैन राइट पी वन वी वन इज इक्वल टू पी टू वी टू. So the value of P1 is 1 bar. The value of V1 is 500 decimeter cubes. You can see that. V2 is 200 decimeter cubes. And P2 you are supposed to find out. So from this equation, P2 is nothing but P1 multiplied by V1 divided by V2. P1 is 1, V1 is 500, V2 is 200. So, P2 is nothing but equal to 2.5 bar. The value of P2 is 2.5 bar. Okay. So, next question. There is a vessel of 120 ml capacity. There is certain amount of gas at 35 degrees Celsius temperature and 1.2 bar pressure. This gas is transferred to another vessel having the volume 180 ml and 35 degrees Celsius. See here also the temperature is constant. Here temperature is constant. Amount of the gas and the temperature is constant. So from Boyle's law what we can write? From Boyle's law what we can write is P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So what is the value of P1? P1 is 1.2 bar, V1 is 120 ml, V2 is 180 ml because it is transferred to another vessel having 180 ml. Before it was 120, so V1 is 120. Initial pressure was 1.2 and the final pressure P2 you are supposed to find out. Put down the values. So P2 is nothing but equal to P1 dot V1 upon V2. P1 1.2, V1 120 divided by 180. So what will be the answer? 0.8 bar. Let us go for the next. Using the equation PV is equal to nRT, show that at given temperature the density of the gas is proportional to the pressure P. Let us see. So we have been given that PV is equal to nRT. PV is nRT, but here what is N? N is number of moles, N is mass of the gas which is small m divided by molecular mass of the gas. The molecular mass of the gas is nothing but capital M. So what we can write is P is equal to nRT upon V. Instead of N, what we can write is M upon M into R into T into V. Now focus, M upon V is nothing but equal to density. So what will be the pressure? Pressure is equal to D dot R dot T upon M. Is it? So from this equation what we can write? D is equal to P dot M upon R dot T. From this equation you can also write that the density of the gas is directly proportional to the pressure of the gas that we are supposed to prove. Next question, at 4 degrees Celsius, the density of a certain oxide of a gas at 2 bar is same as that of dinitrogen at 5 bar. Do gases hain, ek kisi gas ka oxide hai aur dusra nitrogen hai. Dono ki density jo hai wo same di gayi hai alag alag pressures pe. Unke molecular mass ko aapko dhoondna hai. To apne yahan par d is equal to p dot m upon r dot t equation pad liya hai. To kya hum wahan se molecular mass m ki jagah pe d dot r dot t upon p likh sakte hain na. चलिए तो यहां पर मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ ऑक्साइड क्या होगा इट इज डेंसिटी ऑफ ऑक्साइड मल्टीप्लाइड बाय r मल्टीप्लाइड बाय t डिवाइडेड बाय प्रेशर ऑफ ऑक्साइड इन द सेम वे मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इज इक्वल टू डेंसिटी ऑफ नाइट्रोजन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय r मल्टीप्लाइड बाय t डिवाइडेड बाय प्रेशर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन Let us say this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Divide equation 1 by 2. So what will you will get? So you will get M oxide divided by M N2 is equal to D oxide multiplied by P N2. Divided by dN2 multiplied by P oxide. Check. So, M oxide. But D oxide and dN2 are same. The density of the gases are same. So, what we can write? So, we can write that P oxide is equal to pressure of nitrogen gas is 5 bars. Pressure of oxide is 2 bars. 5 upon 2. Now the molecular mass of nitrogen when you put there will be equal to 28 gram per mole. So this will be equal to 28 multiplied by 2.5 which is 70 gram per mole. The molecular mass of the oxide is 70 grams per mole. Moving to the next question. The pressure of 1 gram of ideal gas A at 27 degrees Celsius is found to be 2 bars. Ek gas hai jiska naam hai A. 27 pe uska pressure hai 2 bar. Jab 2 gram dusri gas B ko isi flask ke andar introduce kiya jata hai same temperature pe to pressure jo hai wo badh ke 3 bar ho jata hai. Pehle pressure 2 bar tha. B के introduction के बाद 3 bar हुआ तो कहने का मतलब B का अकेले का pressure 3 minus 2 1 bar होगा इस बात को ध्यान रखना find the relationship between their molecular mass तो हम लोग क्योंकि molecular mass का relation निकालना है P V is equal to nRT पर से P A dot V is equal to N की जगह पे M upon M लिख देते हैं mass upon molecular mass into r dot t hoga pa dot v is equal to ma upon ma into rt likewise if we talk about for gas b pb dot v is equal to mb upon mb into r into t is it okay Now, let us say this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So, divide equation 1 by equation 2. What you will get? PA upon PB is equal to MA upon MB into MB upon NA. Done? Now, what you can write is PA plus PB is equal to 3 bars. That you are knowing, so only PB will be equal to 1 bar. PA is equal to 2 bar. This you are knowing. Now, mass of A is 1 gram. Mass of B is 2 grams. Molecular mass of B in molecular mass of A, you are supposed to find out the relationship. So what you will be finding is MA upon MB is equal to 1 by 4. 1 by 4, is it? So alternatively, you can write, to avoid any confusion, you can write as MB upon MA is equal to 4. So what you can write? MB is equal to 4MA. Is it? Okay. So moving on to the next problem. There is drain cleaner named Drain X. इसके अंदर छोटे से एल्यूमिनियम के बीट्स हैं जो कॉस्टिक सोडा के साथ रिएक्ट करके डाइहाइड्रोजन प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. तो यहाँ पर आपको एल्यूमिनियम दिया गया है, ये कॉस्टिक सोडा के साथ. अब कॉस्टिक सोडा जो है उसको सॉल्वेंट एज अ वाटर में वाटर एज अ सॉल्वेंट लिया गया है. ये जब रिएक्ट करते हैं तब हाइड्रोजन गैस रिलीज होती है और आपका सोडियम एल्यूमिनेट बन जाता है. ठीक है. नाउ if you want to balance this equation, you will have to apply. See, aluminium is one both the sides, sodium is one both the sides, hydrogen, this side it is 3, this side it is 2. So let us balance this equation by 3 and 2 over here. So 2 sodium, so here 2 sodium, here 2 aluminium, so here 2 aluminium. Here there are 4 oxygen atoms, and here only 2. So here also 2, hydrogen gets automatically balanced. Okay. So from this, you can write that 2 multiplied by 27 grams of aluminium is going to give you 3 into 22.4 liters of hydrogen at STP. So can we write that 54 grams of aluminium is equal to 3 into 22.4 liters of hydrogen at STP. So we have been given ke 0.15 gram aluminium kitna produce karega. To 0.15 gram aluminium jo hai kitna produce karega. To 0.186 liters of hydrogen produce hoga kahan par? STP par. STP पे. ठीक है. आपको यहां पर ये जो चीज ढूंढनी है वो 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस और 1 बार पे ढूंढनी है. तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं, यहां पर दो कंडीशंस को डिफाइन कर देते हैं. द फर्स्ट इज एट STP एंड द सेकंड इज गिवन कंडीशंस. एट STP द P1 इज 1 एटमॉस्फेयर, V1 is 0.186 liters, just up we find out kia. Temperature is 273 kelvins. P2 given condition hai 1 bar, temperature T2 20 degree Celsius hai, plus 273 kar do, to kelvin mein aayega, that is 293 kelvin. Volume V2 you are supposed to find out. So applying ideal gas P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. So from this, can you find out V2? V2, just put up the values. You have been given the values. It will be 0.2030 liters, or alternatively it is 203 ml. Done? Okay. So question number 5.7, what will be the pressure exerted by a mixture of 3.2 grams of methane and 4.4 grams of carbon dioxide? So let us find out the moles of both. Number of moles of ethane is equal to 3.2 grams weight upon molecular weight. So let us do some further steps. Moles is equal to weight of methane divided by molecular mass of methane. Weight of methane is 3.2 divided by molecular mass is 16, so it is 0.2 mole. moles of carbon dioxide is molecular mass of carbon dioxide mass of carbon dioxide divided by molecular mass of carbon dioxide. The mass of carbon dioxide is 4.4 divided by 44. So this is equal to 0.1 mole. Now what will be the pressure of methane? It is equal to moles of ethane divided by volume into RT. So this is 0.2 divided by V into R dot T. At the same time, PCO2 is equal to 0.1 divided by V into RT. Now the mixture will have the pressure is equal to PCH4 plus PCO2. CH4 is 0.2 RT upon V, plus this is 0.1 RT upon V. So can we keep this as common? So RT upon V is common, in bracket 0.2 plus 0.1. So 0.3 multiplied by R's value 0.082. The temperature is 300 Kelvin. Because it is 27 degrees Celsius, so 27 plus 273, that is 300 Kelvin. The volume of the gas is 9 decimeters cube. So this is 0.821 atmosphere. So 0.821, convert this atmosphere into Pascal if you want to. 101325. So this will be equal to 8.318 into 10 to the power 4 Pascal. Moving on to the next question, question number 5.8. What will be the pressure of the gaseous mixture when 0.5 liters of hydrogen at 0.8 bar and 2.0 liters of dioxygen at 0.7 bar are introduced in 1 liters of vessel? Let us say we are calculating the partial pressures of both the gases, that is hydrogen and oxygen, and ultimately we'll add up them. Okay, so the partial pressure of hydrogen gas. So for hydrogen gas, V1 is 0.5 liters. The final volume is 1 liter, so V2 is equal to V2 is 1 liter. This is introduced in the 1 liter flask. Here the pressure was 0.8 bar and here the pressure you are supposed to find out. The temperature remains the same, you can check. So from Boyle's law, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2, you can have the value of P2 as 0.4 bar. In the same way, the partial pressure of dioxygen gas is V1 is equal to 2.0 liters. It was initially in 2 liters. It is introduced in ultimately 1 liters. The pressure is 0.7 bar. Ultimate pressure P2 you are supposed to find out. So what is P2? P2 is P1 V1 upon V2. 0.7 multiplied by 2 divided by 1. The answer is 1.40 bar. So the pressure of gas mixture P is 0.4 bar plus 1.40 bar. The answer is 1.80 bar. Moving on to the next question. Density of a gas is found to be 5.46 grams per decimeter cube at 27 degrees Celsius 2 bar pressure. What is the density at STP? So we know that PV is equal to nRT. We are knowing that PV is equal to nRT, or we can write that P is equal to M upon V into RT upon M. Why? Because N is equal to small m divided by capital M. Now you are knowing that this is density, so it is equal to D upon M into RT. Alternatively, you can write that D is equal to P dot M upon R dot T. This we already have derived. So now you can see that from here you can have the idea that density of the gas is directly proportional to pressure and temperature. Why? Because in both the cases the gas are same, so molecular mass and the temperature will remains the sorry molecular mass and the value of R will remain the same. These two quantities will remain same, so we can write that D1 upon D2 is equal to P1 upon T1, here it is P2 and here it is T2. Or since we are interested for value of D2, it is equal to D1 T1 P2 divided by P1 multiplied by T2. So put the values. D1 is 5.46 gram per decimeter cube, P1 is equal to 2 bar, P2 is equal to 1 bar, T1 is equal to 300 Kelvin, T2 is 273 Kelvin. So put the values as D2 is equal to 5.46, temperature is 300, pressure is 1, it is 2, T2 is 273. So what will be the value of D2 as? The value of D2 is 3.0 grams per decimeter cube. Moving on to the next problem, 5.10, 34.05 ml of phosphorus vapors weigh 0.0625 grams at 546 degree Celsius and 0.1 bar pressure. What is the molecular mass of phosphorus? So we are knowing that PV is equal to nRT. This is what you can say, weight upon molecular weight. So M upon mRT. PV is equal to, or can we write that M is equal to M dot R dot T upon P dot V. What is M? The M is 0.0625, R is 0.083, temperature is 546 plus 273, that is 819. So 819 over here, the pressure is 0.1, volume of the gas is 34.05, it is ml. Convert this into liter, so it is divided by 1000. The answer will be equal to 1247.74 gram per mole. Question number 11 onwards, we will be discussing in the next session. Thank you.